Side kind of thing. Yeah.
Right, Aki Kareem, yeah, British Boxers. No, we're over here in Moss Side today at Cafe Nubia. We've got John Telford with us. John, just talk us through what's in that milk, that shake you got there, man.
What's in it? Apple, spinach, kale, cucumber, green stuff, man. Anything green you can think of, it's
anything
in there.
Green's in there.
Yeah, man.
The life of a fighter. Do you like all that sort of stuff?
Yeah, I do, you know. Yeah,
you
man.
Like it? Yeah. Well, obviously, we've got to talk about this big fight you got coming up, mate.
Yep.
Matthew Wigglesworth, Central Area title.
Yep.
I believe it's also now an English title eliminator.
I believe so, yeah. I think it's been applied for since the fight's been made.
It possibly could be then, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, it's a good fight, this. A lot of people talking about it. And every time people talk about it, they seem to mention the word war. But, I mean, talk to me, man. How do you see this fight going?
We'll see, won't we? Yeah, I think I can make it how I want to make it, to be honest with you, but... Yeah, we'll see. Like, I feel like I have more to my game than that, than just say, oh, it's war or nothing. Like,
yeah.
I feel like I've got more to my game than that. Like,
yeah, in a way, it's kind of selling your skills short, isn't it?
Yeah,
but both of you, both of you have got boxing skills.
Probably jab, selling both of our skills short. Yeah, yeah. No, not just myself. I think it's selling both of us short. Yeah.
What do you think about Wigglesworth as a fighter? You know, obviously, I know you're a respectful guy, and you're not going to slag him off or anything. But you know, what do you think about what are his strengths to his game, and you know, what are his weaknesses to his game?
I haven't watched too much of him, to be honest. But yeah, from what I've seen, he likes to work quite a lot. And like I say, I'd never really took notice, or I'd never heard of him before the Ben Sheedy fight. Like, I just thought it was a formality. He was brought in to be beaten, and obviously ripped up the script, didn't he, and did his own thing. And yeah, good on him, man. Yeah, respect to him.
Yeah, well, you get a chance to rip up the script this time, don't you?
Yeah,
going
man.
To Hull as well.
Yeah,
I mean, are you sort of gutted in a way that it's not in Manchester, or does that not faze you, the travelling?
Nah, I'm up for this, you know. Like, it takes a lot of the pressure off. Like,
yeah
it's not, cause it's not for me. All that fucking having to graft, sell tickets and fucking all that every day. Nah, it's cool, man. Like, let him do all that and I'll just chill, man. I like it, man. We'll do this more often,
going into the danger zone.
Yeah, like I say, it's the first time in it, but yeah, I think so. Like, yeah, man.
Well, obviously the fight's 9th of March, so you've still got a fair bit of time to...
Yeah, well, it's 6 weeks tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
And you've always been known as a tough sort of come forward fighter. However, today you've been working, well, in general, you've been working more on your movement and things like that as well to round your game.
Yeah, like, I think, like, to be fair, I've never really shown, like, I know it's a fucking cliche thing, I don't really want to say it, but like, a lot of people say, oh, like, you've only seen 25% of me, you've only seen 50% of me, but I genuinely do believe that. So, like, I feel like from the outside looking in, looking at, like, if you'd never seen me, never trained me, never nothing, I think you'd look at my performance and say, yeah, it's fucking shit. You know what I mean? And I won't blame him for thinking so. I've got a lot more to my game, man, and just having the fights to show it, so to speak. Yeah, man.
Why do you think it is that we haven't seen the best of John in the ring, you know, so far then, to date?
I don't know. Good question. It's not because I've not wanted to. I don't know. Maybe I just need to raise to the person in with level, so to speak. If that makes sense. People talk about rising to levels and stuff like that, and I think it's the case for myself here. And I've always found that myself sparring. I've sparred some of the best in the country, which is the best in the world in a lot of cases. And I know sparring, fighting. But there is similarities in the thing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I find that myself. Like, the better people are sparred, the better I perform, so does that make sense, yeah?
Well, with this particular fight, Wigglesworth's the sort of fighter who's quite a relentless sort of guy.
Yep.
Very fit, well-conditioned, just like yourself.
Yep.
So, essentially, he is going to bring the best out of you, isn't he?
Yeah,
you're going to have to be at your best.
Yeah, man, 100%. And like I said, I think he'll raise my game.
Is this the sort of fight you think you'll have to be literally at your very best to win? Or do you think you can do it and have a bad night and still win the fight?
No, like I said, I don't want to be disrespectful, but like, no, I think I've got more than the tools to do the job, man. Like I said, I think I can win it how I want to win it, and that's not being rude, that's just how I feel, you know what I mean?
You've been sort of looking for this Central Area title fight for a while.
Yeah, man.
So in a sense, you know, why is it so important for you to get this title under your belt?
I said, I've always wanted to do, since I turned pro, I've wanted to do the traditional route, I've always wanted to do the Central Area. A lot of people skip the Central Area and feel as though they're better than that and whatever, but now that's always been the first one I've wanted to tick off the list, man, 100%, yeah.
You've been around boxing your whole life, haven't you?
I've
been around boxing your whole life, really, haven't you? You know, from a young guy.
Yeah, like, I've had my first amateur fight at 15, so what, I'm 24 now, so coming up 10 years now, yeah. Well, it'll be 10 years this year since my first amateur fight, yeah. Yeah, man.
And even though you've not had that many pro fights, it's almost like you feel like a veteran on the circuit, in a sense.
Yeah, so to speak. Yeah, like, I've been in there with everyone, like, like I said, I don't want to fucking mope on about the sparring and all that, but like, yeah, I've been around, man. I've sparred the who's who, man. Yeah, I've been about here, man.
You think people might be underrating your chances in this fight?
Yeah. Possibly so. And like, I wouldn't blame them, like I was just saying about my performances. I wouldn't blame them for looking at my performance and say, yeah, it's shitting. I won't blame you, man. Yeah, I'd probably agree with you, you know what I mean? But now I know I've got more to my game than that. It's just bringing, having the fights to show that. Yeah, man. And this will be the one.
This will be the one. Are you taking a few of the boys there for this fight? You know, from the gym, everyone coming out. I know you guys always come out to support each other.
Yeah, man. Yeah, we all go to each other's fights, and yeah, this one will be no different, man. They'll all be coming down. Yeah, man.
All right, man. Well, I'm looking forward to this fight, really, genuinely. Because second I saw it, it's one of them fights where you look at the styles and you think, yeah, they gel nice.
Yeah, man.
So looking forward to it and hoping to get you guys on a head to head as well.
Yeah, man, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Yeah, Matthew Wigglesworth, let's do a head to head, man. Let's do it. Yeah, man.
All right, man. Yeah, man. Good to speak to you, John.
Yes, you too.
Catch up with you soon as the camp develops.
Yeah, man. Nice one, Matthew. Yeah, man.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.